humans. Dominant life form on Earth, capable of great technological marvels and constant innovation. Now, how did we become such wondrous people? Life faces many challenges to survive. In the journey, humanity has beaten all odds. This presentation illustrates the great cultural wealth and knowledge found in the Vedas and its relevance in the modern world. A highly developed scientific technique of the mind, which can be developed only under the guidance of a virtuous guru. A gurukul in this man-eat-man world? Impossible. This is where we are wrong, and this is what Acharya has done. Make the impossible possible. Acharya has tried for and is still striving to teach mankind and show that the spiritual path has no boundaries. Acharya Sri, a staunch follower of Swami Dayananda Saraswati's teaching, brought thousands into his fold, teaching them at first the basic acharanas, the Panchamahayagnam and the 16 samskaras. Kashyapa Veda Research Foundation, founded by Acharya, is a result of Acharya's untiring efforts of the past 15 to 20 years. This untiring effort of Acharya, a very powerful instrument, brought a revolution in the social fabric of Kerala, like uniting the humanity on the principle of universal Vedic values and culture, in order to free the world from rift and sorrow and to live in peace, harmony and happiness. The biggest achievements in the history of mankind are the culmination of efforts which had small beginnings. At a time when Kerala was being butchered by communism and Hindus were feeling directionless, stranded and battered, chaos and confusion was the order of the day. Religiously, they were confused. Ambassadors of other religion were looking down upon the Hindus for conversion. And aggravating matters further was the onslaught of the Western culture and the attraction of the society towards Westernization. At a time in which mass communication has made it easy to reach out to the people, there were no great leaders to analyze and articulate the ills of the day, much less offer solution. Discourses upon discourses and talks were being held, but there was no solution. Myriad problems were taking people in circles, and those who can raise their voice maintain inexplicable silence on the rising atrocities within the family and society. Increasing number of people, thousands and thousands, flocked to the temples to wish away their miseries. A state of social stagnation. Old evils were being reinvented in more virulent forms because there was no one or no desire to invest time and energy in identifying and fixing the problem. The cult of various gurus rose, and their personal affluence soared high in direct proportion as society languished in escapism and despair. It was at this juncture there rose from anonymity a young man by name M.R. Rajesh, who broke with tradition and defied convention with a vision and mission to teach Vedas to all and sundry, due to which he had to sacrifice and suffered a lot. In Nambudiri Brahmin, his community ostracized him as he was teaching Vedas to the so-called lesser mortals. Acharya realized that the existing plight of the people is due to their losing touch with the teachings as per the Vedas. Progress can be achieved if the spiritual and economic foundation go hand in hand. He raised his voice against social inequality, bigotry, black magic, and so on. He was not a supporter of monastic Vedanta, mere philosophy without the capability of putting into practice is of no use, and rituals without rationale are mere superstitions. Rituals also motivate men to live in peace and harmony in order to enjoy in abundance the beauties and benefits of Mother Nature. Many yajnas on a mass scale have been arranged and performed in different parts of Kerala and also Delhi and Dubai. Yajnas found a new Yajna Prajapati to spread their message. Hence, Kerala witnessed a series of various rites from Rudra to Gayatri and from Pavitreshti to Brihaspadeshti. In spite of Dubai being an Islamic state, more than 5,000 people turned up for the Saraswati Yajna this year. Somayaga, lasting 7 days, performed in 2014 February, drew masses from different parts of India and world over. More than 13 lakh people witnessed this yajna. The very same yajna was a blend of creative ideas and pragmatic approach. Maybe for the first time in the history of India, Adivasis were received with warmth, Agni and Vedamandra by the Brahmins to the Yagashala. Annadhanam was there from morning to night, and the importance of this Annadhanam was a staple food, that is rice, was cultivated for the sole purpose of this yaga, so as to give people pesticide-free food. It was also a plastic-free event. Acharya had also distributed seeds and saplings of different vegetables to Shishyas, so that they were ready in time for the yaga to be served to the people. 10 days before the Somayaga, nearly 1,800 people performed Agnihotra under a single marquee in individual homakunds. The continuous chanting of Veda Mantra, Murajabam, is being conducted in KVRF for the past 3 years. Veda Vijayara classes are being conducted outside the ashramam for those who cannot come to the ashramam for the Vedic studies. KVRF has also been started in Wayanad and Kannur. A new Gurukulam is under construction at Ottathenga in Calicut. Nearly 2,500 people performed Agnihotra there on 14th August 2014. In Thanur, a 3-day Chaturveda Yajnam was conducted. The program was flagged off by a big procession comprising of all of Acharya Shishyas and witnessed by hundreds. In the last day, more than 6,000 people took part in it. Love and compassion for all lives are of prime significance. Acharya teaches us not only the Vedas, but also to protect the environment by planting trees and conserving trees which are on the verge of extinction under the name of Dhyanandamani. In the quest to modernize agriculture, chemical pesticides and fertilizers were used, which promoted an increasing use of high-yielding crop varieties. The situation displays the farmers' knowledge, own seeds and practices, and were caught in the whirlwind of socio-ecological and economic crisis. If agriculture is to survive and change, it is only through her cow and her progeny. It will not only increase the fertility of the soil, but will also make the people healthy and prosperous. For this, we need the indigenous variety which are now on the verge of extinction. Acharya Sri educated and made people aware of the Indian cows and the need of cow protection and preservation. It was not just a walk and talk. Acharya put into practice by going to the field to sow and reap. As the old adage says, practice makes perfect. Acharya turned this into a mass movement, and many are into farming and cattle rearing on a small scale. This has instigated others to follow suit. Still, there is a lot of constructive work to be done. Acharya Sri has authored many books. Most of them are bestsellers, out of which Arshabharatathile Gomamsa Bhakshanam has created ripples in the society and has made many people sit up and take notice, since the issue being a current one. Kashyapa Veda Research Foundation feeds the needy in different parts of the city. During festivals, food is distributed among the genuinely poor and the needy. Acharya Sri's life is a testimony of his helpless service to humanity. Through his work, he is not only bringing countless human beings close to their essential selves, but together the human community as a whole. And of course, there are many milestones to reach. Present times are particularly suitable for major changes in people's life. There are times when shifts are happening, from material to the spiritual, from illness to wellness. Unavoidable circumstances are compelling people to evolve. Catastrophe like cancer and loss of job are forcing people to introspect. Awareness is generated in social networking platforms like Twitter and Facebook and is spreading like wildfire. The big effort of a single personality is getting shared, recognized and lauded. People are joining hands, coming together, creating forum to speak upon love, likes, relationships and wisdom, giving hope to tired souls. New opinions are getting formed, old ones are crumbling, and people are gradually coming out of their self cocoons. Indeed, times are changing for a better world, for a beautiful journey called life, with a guru, yes, a spiritual guru with a difference, a blend of profundity and pragmatism.